Equity markets were lower on Wednesday, but the E-mini S&Ps remain above that key 2800, which is the level that I think we've sort of hung our hat on. We haven't seen a settle below 2800 going back to the second week of March. And I think that right now the market kind of is waiting for some kind of a catalyst event that may nudge us back to the highs or trip us up and continue the sell-off. Obviously, the economies, not only here in the U.S., but globally are having an effect on that. We've got the Brexit issues going on, trade deals with China. And I think that ultimately the U.S. yield curve could start to prevent equities from going higher. I think you're hearing two sides of that argument. One, that it will continue to push equities higher is the lack of yield. Two is that the crossing of those inversion of the yield curve creates some uncertainty I think risk assets tend to suffer on. I think that the Fed probably won't get involved in that, what we call the Greenspan, Bernanke, Yellen, now Powell put, unless we see a substantial sell-off in equities. And that's something that I don't think we'll see, at least in the short term. I think right now the market's more focused on the economies. What happened to all that growth we were talking about? What happened to the fast-paced economy that we had? Yeah, jobs are great, but we're starting to see some leaks in the boat in other areas, whether it be housing or manufacturing. And I think that those are two that we're going to see it in growth numbers for the first quarter of this year. As expected, they're going to be much lower. And I think those are things that need to be raised in some concern. I think if you look at the VIX index, it's very low here. Yes, it's off the lows, the recent lows that we had, but you know, VIX index trading around 15 and not seeing much of a move today suggests that there isn't a whole lot of fear priced into this, so that the market doesn't anticipate any kind of sell-off because of the aforementioned Fed might be stepping in to hold the market up, or the lack of yield in the Treasury side may be there to make stocks more attractive. And I think that the sell-off could come. It might catch many off guard. There is still a lot of asset allocation into equities. They remain very high a percentage of portfolios. And I think that if you start to see a move down, maybe 5-6% declines, it could start to really gather some steam. Now, we haven't gotten there yet. And I think that the key level that we're looking at is 2600, which is way down there as we sit above 2800. But the VIX index really not showing any concern over the short term. And that may be a little bit troublesome. Lastly, let's look at what we have coming up ahead. Yeah, we'll continue to keep an eye on China and we'll continue to keep on the U.S. trade negotiations there. How are they going to pan out? How are they going to help or hurt the U.S. economy? Likewise, we had a Brexit vote today, or several, I should mention. The fallout from those, especially with Prime Minister May likely stepping down after phase one of the Brexit, and that will obviously play a key part in global growth. Lastly, the Fed. Well, the Fed's been whispering that there isn't a need to cut rates. Well, why would they tell us there isn't a need to cut rates if there wasn't a need to cut rates? The market's telling you that there's likely a rate cut coming in 2019. I think the Fed's trying to jump in front of that, tell you that it isn't necessary. I think that the inversion of the yield curve is another indicator that the Fed may be looking or may need to cut rates, but they're jumping in front again, telling you there's no need for it. And I never believe anything the Fed says until it is first denied. So at this point, we know now that the Fed says there is no need to cut rates. But we'll know after first quarter, I think, when we see those growth numbers, manufacturing and housing numbers, if they continue on their path, it will certainly lead to a rate cut, possibly not until the second half of this year. But equity markets will react very oddly, I think. If the economy starts to weaken and the Fed looks to cut rates again, it could fuel equities higher in the short term. But ultimately, I think that the Fed doesn't have a whole lot of ammo in its arsenal to be able to cut rates. So it's going to have to get creative, and that may cause equity markets to stutter a little bit. So right now, equity markets on the decline, but certainly holding above that key 2800 level. We'll see what happens with the rest of the week. We have some data, and likewise, we'll hear from more Fed speakers. Can it stay above 2800 heading into the weekend and into month end? That is yet to be seen.